Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In this video, you take a look at how to use 3D render passes that have been rendered in a 3D application, such as Autodesk Maya or Autodesk 3ds Max, and use them within the Flame's 3D compositor action. The benefit to you is that even though these render passes are flat 2D images, you can access the render pass data in action and treat your 2D pixels as if they were still in 3D space. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast version of this video, then please type the link displayed in your favorite web browser. Now, starting off in a fresh batch group, drag out the import node, and this will take you to the media browser. Next, navigate to the downloaded media. Now, before you import this material, set the color management tagging to Scene Linear Rec 709 sRGB. This material was rendered as linear, and the color space needs to be correct to give the expected results. As a side note, if you double-click on the multi tag, this will expose all the render passes embedded in this OpenEXR. You have an alpha, z depth, normals, motion vectors, and object IDs. You'll use all these channels in action, so select the main clip and import it into batch. By default, you get a multi-channel clip that contains all the render passes. If you select the clip and toggle the F4 keyboard shortcut, you can look through all the embedded render passes. Coming back to the batch schematic, just select the clip and press Shift-C to uncollapse it. Now you could composite using the render passes as various processes in the node flow graph. But ultimately, these are single processes without too much flexibility. The alternative approach is to push all this 3D data and combine it into the Action 3D Composite. This gives you access to a wider variety of 3D tools, as well as combining your render passes with any other 3D compositing in action. So drag out a fresh action node. Now I am using the legacy color management in this project, so action is unaware of its color space. This could be pre-configured if you are using a different color management policy, or changing the setting in the main color management preferences. But you also have control at the node level. So you can either change the node preferences, or just connect the clip into the action background to adopt the clip settings, and then disconnect the clip. Now you have the beauty pass and four data passes to work with. So select the action node and press Ctrl-N for 5 media inputs. Now connect all the render passes. Even though the data passes won't be composited themselves, you still add them into action the same way as regular media. Switch to the action controls and call up a 2-up view with the action schematic and result view. Now delete all the image objects except for the actual beauty pass. So switching to the node bin, the render passes are loaded in the media list, and you're ready to inject the 3D data passes into the main 2D beauty render pass. Select the image object in the action schematic, and select the Z depth pass in the media list. Switch the node bin to maps, and here you will find all the components you can feed into the image. Find the Z-depth map and drag it into the schematic. Next, select the normals map in the media list and add that as a normals map node. Repeat the same for motion vectors and the same for the object ID map. Now, some of these maps need a slight tweaking before using them. Firstly, double-click the Motion Vectors map and change the Motion Vectors setting to Forward and Backward. The Motion Vectors are supplied in the render pass, so no analysis is required. Finally, the Z depth looks totally white, so you need to remap the values to expose the Z depth information. You'll use a color correction matchbox to achieve this. Select the Z depth map object and switch to the action node bin. Choose the matchbox tab and apply a color correction shader to the node. To see the output of this particular render pass, ensure it is selected and change the result view to the object view with F8. Call up the color correction controls and switch to the controls menu. Enable the scene linear input and adjust the first histogram slider to 2.5. You use the color correct matchbox shader instead of the color corrector or color warper because this GLSL shader is processing at 32-bit and not 16-bit. So all this data is retained. Go back to the result view with F4. The Z-depth data pass was also rendered in absolute values, so remember to switch the input type to the right depth range. Now the whole point of bringing these data passes into action is to use them, as well as combining them with Action's 3D environment. So let's first consider applying effects onto the image object. Say you wanted to add depth of field to the shot. This is typically achieved using the beauty pass and the Z-depth pass. So you need to use a multi-channel shader to create the effect on the image. Select the image object and through the contextual menu, add a matchbox shader. Scroll to the bottom of the browser and choose the depth of field shader. The shader attaches itself to the surface object and the result view is now blurred. For your extra knowledge, switch to the shader menu and you can see the three inputs required by this shader in order to function. Now let's focus the depth of field. Switch to the controls menu and enable the viewing option. To set the focal point, push the Z position into a negative range around 3,500. So hopefully it's clear where the depth of field will be. Disable the viewing option to see the result. So you can add various matchbox shaders to influence the render pass at the image level. But the whole point of bringing the render passes into action is to use them in conjunction with the other 3D tools. For instance, you could call up the contextual menu and add a light into the 3D scene. With the normals pass attached to the beauty pass, the light attempts to shade the image as if it was still 3D and not a flat 2D render. So that's relighting based on the normals render pass. But if you were to select the Z depth object and enable displace vertices under the rendering header, you get a completely different lighting result. Grab the light and push it all the way back in Z space. Moving its position coordinates using displace vertices allows you to apply the Z depth as part of the Action 3D composite. So the lighting reacts more naturally to the light's position in 3D space, but it also allows you to create occlusions with lights. For example, resetting the lighting position actually pushes it behind the walls in terms of 3D space. You can see how the light is occluding in different positions. This can create some really nice moody lighting. So you can get a variety of outcomes using these render passes with 3D lighting. I don't want this for our example, so delete the light and disable shading through the Action Render Preferences menu. Now to ensure these data passes are fully accessible to Action, as well as further down the node flow graph, a great habit to get into is to go through each of the render pass maps and enable them as Action render passes where possible. This means you can apply effects on the image level as you have seen, but you can also apply them on the composite level with camera effects. This means you can apply post-processing effects based on this data, rather than Action's own 3D environment. For example, select the camera and add a camera effect through the contextual menu. In the list, choose Motion Blur. When you adjust the exposure time, the motion blur is applied to the entire composite. So any other elements you may composite with this image will be affected by the motion vectors. This will help with any element integration. Here are a couple more multi-channel matchbox shaders that will help further refine the final look development. Add another camera effects to the camera. Choose the Color Correct 3D Selective. So let's add a bit of color to the floor. Drag the wheel to a color tint of your choice. Of course, this affects the whole composite, so switch to the selective controls in the pull-down menu. Switch the type to Object IDs. Display the Object IDs and pick the color of the floor with the color pot. Turning off the ID display, only the pixels which make up the floor will have the color change. You can add as many color correct nodes as you like to change all sorts of objects. Add another camera effects to the camera. In the browser, choose the blooming camera effects. Switch to the selective menu and disable exclude background. So all the brightest areas of the scene are blooming. In the selective menu, switch the selective type to Object IDs. As before, display the IDs and choose the wall of the room. Turning off the ID display, only the walls are blooming but not the floor. So I think you get the general idea of how to load render passes into Action and apply them in a new and creative way to really tweak your look development. Don't forget that you can also output these passes using the Action outputs, and the render passes can be used further down the batched flow graph for even more creative development. This is the before and the after. Don't forget to also check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.